Year 9, and welcome to the BTEC Sport and Outdoor Activities Options video. Now, before I talk to you about the Sport and Outdoor Activities course and what you'll be doing in Year 10 and Year 11, I want you to watch a short video that shows some current students and students in the past undertaking the course.
King Kong banging on your chest. You could beat the world, you could beat the war. You could talk the guy, go banging on his door. You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock. You can move a mountain, you can break rocks. You could be a master, don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you can find yourself. Straight through hell with a smile.
You could be the hero, you get the gold. Breaking all the records he thought never could be broke.
Yeah, do it for your people, do it for your pride. You're never gonna know if you never even try.
Do it for your country, do it for your name. Cause there's gonna be a day when you're
standing in the hall of fame.
Okay, so hopefully that's given you a little bit of a flavour of the type of things that you would be doing if you were to do the BTEC course next year. Now, the BTEC Sport course is a vocational course, so it's worth the same as a GCSE, but how you're assessed is slightly different. In the GCSEs, you will study the course for 2 years and then you'll have the exam at the end, whereas in the BTEC Sport course, you will be assessed constantly through the 2 years of you doing the course. Now, what you will study are 4 units. One of the units, Unit 1, Fitness for Sport and Exercise, this is an externally assessed unit where you will do a 70-minute exam at the end of doing the content. And Units 2, 3 and 4, they are internally assessed units and they're assessed through the method of coursework. Now, Unit 1, as I said, is the exam, and in that you'll be covering content such as the component of fitness. So there are 9 components of fitness. You'll learn all about those, how you train to improve those components of fitness, and how you test those components to see if you've made any progress. You'll be looking at heart rate and exercise intensity, how the level of exercise that you do, so how hard you work, how that affects your heart rate, and then how that affects your fitness overall. You'll be looking at the principles of training, so what training is and the elements of it. And then you'll look at the different training methods, so what can you do to actually improve your fitness. Unit two is your practical, it's practical sports performance, and you actually do unit two over year 10 and year 11. Now, there are two pathways that you can follow. One of them is the outdoor activities pathway, and one of them is the sport pathway. Now, the outdoor activities pathway, you will do mountain biking, and we do that at Grisdale Forest or in different areas in the Lake District. We do skiing, and you do that at Kendall Ski Slope. And you do climbing, which we do in the school climbing wall. We do use the leisure centre, and we also use Kendall climbing wall as well. If you follow the sport pathway, you'll do the more traditional sports that you've been doing through your time at school already. So you'll be doing football, you could be doing netball, even doing trampolining, you could be doing badminton, rounders, cricket, rugby, all the sports that you know already and maybe taking part in. Now, unit three is training for personal fitness. In this unit, you will be learning all about the physiology of the body, and these are the body systems, your muscular system, the skeletal system, your respiratory and your cardiovascular system. So you'll be learning how these systems are affected when you are doing exercise and what happens to your body when you're doing exercise. You're also going to design a personal training program. So you'll learn all about training programs and how they can help improve your fitness. You're then going to follow the training program that you've designed, and you're going to do that training program for 6 weeks. The final unit, unit four, is all about sports leadership. And this is where you learn about the skills, qualities, and responsibilities that a sports leader needs to have. You will plan a sports activity session, and then you're going to lead that, and you're going to teach other people that activity session. Now, as well as the four units that are part of the course, you'll also develop additional skills and qualities by doing the course. You'll develop your communication skills, your problem-solving skills, your decision-making skills, your ability to work with others, and you'll also develop a positive can-do attitude. Now, once you complete the course, what can you do with it? Well, there's different pathways. You can go to college, you can either go to Furness College, or you can go to sixth form. And you can do the level 3 BTEC sport, or you can do A-level PE. You can do outdoor activity leadership courses, you can do sports development, coaching and fitness courses, you can do personal training at level 3 and above. So there's lots of courses you can do at college. There's lots of careers in the sport industry as well. It's one of the biggest industries in the United Kingdom. You could be a sports coach, you can go into coaching, physiotherapy, you can be a fitness trainer, you can go into sports development and local authorities, you could become an outdoor activities instructor, and dare I say, you could even become a teacher as well. Now, there are only two prerequisites in order to do the course. One is you need to have an interest in sport or outdoor activities, and the second one is you need to have a willingness to work hard and try. Now, I hope this video has given you more of an insight into what the course is all about and the type of things that you're going to be doing, and it's answered any questions that you might have. If you do have any questions, come and speak to any of the PE department in the PE office, or come and find me in my office and we will do our best to answer any question that you have.